Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Getting Started with the HMC 8012 Digital Multimeter. In this presentation, we'll explain how to configure and use the different measurement functions of the Rohde & Schwarz HMC 8012. Let's start with a brief overview of the HMC. The Rohde & Schwarz HMC 8012 is a benchtop 5¾ digit multimeter suitable for both lab and production use. It can make true RMS measurements of both AC and combined AC plus DC, and it can display up to 3 measurement functions simultaneously, for example, DC, AC, and statistics. The main measurement functions of the HMC include DC and AC voltage and current, frequency, 2 and 4 wire resistance, temperature, and capacitance, as well as diode and continuity testing. Results are presented numerically with common statistical values, and special measurements such as limit testing, DC power, and dB or dBm values are also supported. Measurement values can be logged in CSV format, either internally or to an attached USB drive, and the HMC can also be remotely controlled or automated over LAN, USB, and GPIB interfaces. In the remainder of this presentation, we'll go step by step through the main measurements and features of the HMC 8012. Let's start with an overview of the front panel. Soft menu keys are used to view and configure most of the measurement parameters. The center group of hard keys is used to select the measurement function, DC volts, AC volts, resistance, etc. But they can also be used as a numeric keypad by pressing the shift key. The system keys above the shift key are used for basic instrument configuration, saving and recalling settings, and accessing the built-in help function. The rotary knob and cursors can be used to navigate menus or to change parameter values. Below this are standard size voltage, current, and common jacks, which are connected to the device under test. A pair of sense connectors are also provided for making 4-wire resistance measurements. And above these are controls for holding, nulling, and triggering measurements. The 8 most important measurements on the HMC 8012 are voltage, current, power, resistance, continuity or diode measurements, frequency, capacitance, and temperature. In the following sections, we'll provide detailed information on how to configure and make each of these measurements. Most multimeter measurements require a range to be set, and the easiest way to do this on the HMC is using the AutoRange function, which senses the measured quantity and sets the range automatically. Ranges can also be set manually using the Range Up and Range Down soft keys. Manually defining the range can reduce measurement time compared to using AutoRange, and may also provide greater measurement accuracy in some cases. The type of ranging and the range value are displayed in the measurement result pane, and the word overrange will be displayed if the measured value is outside of the configured range. Voltage measurements are made by pressing either the DC volts or AC volts hard keys. A special symbol behind the V indicates whether DC or AC is being measured. On the front panel, the V and COM jacks are used to connect to the measured voltage. And note that AC voltage measurements made by the HMC 8012 are always true RMS voltage values, which provides an accurate value even for non-sinusoidal AC signals. Direct and alternating current are measured by pressing the DCI or ACI hard keys. As before, a symbol following the result indicates if the measured value is DC or AC. Connections to the circuit under test are made using the A and COM jacks. But note that the HMC 8012 must be placed in line with the current in order to measure it. In other words, the circuit must be broken and the current must flow through the HMC in order to make a current measurement. AC plus DC mode can simultaneously display DC voltage with an overlapping or superimposed AC voltage, or a direct current with an overlapping alternating current. This mode is selected by pressing the measure hard key and then the AC plus DC soft key. As with other AC measurements on the HMC 8012, these are true RMS measured values. Note that in order to select this mode, an AC voltage or AC current measurement must be active. In addition to separate voltage and current measurements, the HMC8012 can calculate power by making simultaneous voltage and current measurements. This function is activated by pressing the Measure Hard key and then selecting Power. Note too that this option is only available if DC or AC current measurements are selected. During operation, the display in this mode shows the voltage, the current, and the calculated power. The resistance of the connecting wires is also taken into account by this measurement. If a non-zero value is entered, the voltage drop caused by the wire resistance will be automatically subtracted from the calculated power, and this in turn will provide a more accurate measurement of the power present at the load. Power measurement requires the simultaneous use of the A, COM, and V ports. The positive poles of the source and load are connected to the V jack of the HMC, and the negative pole of the source is connected to the load through the HMC using the A and COM jacks. The resulting measurement calculates the power at this measurement plane, which can then be corrected to power at the load by means of the wire resistance parameter. Next, let's look at resistance measurements, which are enabled by pressing the Ohm or Omega hard key. Resistance is measured by connecting to the V and COM jacks. In this case, the polarity of the cables is not important. Note that when measuring very small resistances, zeroing is recommended. Zeroing applies an offset correction to remove the effect of cables, contact resistance, etc. from the measurement. The zeroing process is performed by shorting the measurement cables or leads together, and then pressing the Null hard key on the front of the HMC. Greater measurement accuracy can be obtained by making a 4-wire resistance measurement. This is done by changing from 2-wire mode to 4-wire mode under the Mode menu. In this case, in addition to the standard 2-wire connection we saw on the previous slide, another pair of leads is connected from the low-high sense connectors to a point close to the measured resistance. In this way, the HMC can compensate for the resistance in the measurement leads, and this in turn improves accuracy for very low resistances. Next, we'll look at diode and continuity testing. For both of these measurements, connections are made to the V and COM jacks. In diode mode, the HMC will apply a voltage and display the forward voltage drop across the diode. In this example, 2.6 volts. In continuity mode, the word open or the resistance between the leads is displayed. An audible beep indicating continuity can also be enabled. Both diode testing and continuity testing have a user-configurable measurement threshold. The HMC can measure the frequency of a signal when the main measurement result is set to either AC volts or AC current. The result is displayed in Hertz together with the voltage or current. The gate time parameter defines the period over which the frequency is measured, and this can be set to 10 milliseconds, 100 milliseconds, or 1 second. Higher or longer gate times will provide higher resolution, that is, a greater number of digits in the measurement result. Capacitance measurements are enabled using the CAP hard key. Connections to the capacitor under test are made using the V and COM jacks, and results are displayed in units of farads. Be sure to observe the polarity when measuring polarized capacitors. And as with resistance measurements, capacitor measurement accuracy can be improved by zeroing, that is, by shorting the leads and pressing the Null hard key before making measurements. The HMC can measure temperature by using various types of probes. The resistance of these probes changes with temperature, so they are connected in the same way as for resistance measurements, namely to the V and COM jacks. The menu item PT type allows selection of the probe type, PT100, PT500, or PT1000, as well as the number of wires, 2 or 4. Note that larger PT numbers indicate higher temperature measuring capability. The units of temperature can also be set to Celsius, Kelvin, or Fahrenheit. Now that we've covered the basic measurements, we'll spend the remainder of this presentation discussing some additional functions and features of the HMC 8012. These are the multi-value display, results in dB or dBm, the effects of ADC rate, triggering, statistics, limit testing, data logging, and remote control. Let's start by looking at the HMC's multi-value display. For some measurements, the HMC 8012 can display up to three measurement values simultaneously. The primary value in the middle of the display is voltage or current, either AC or DC. Pressing the soft key second function enables display of a second value, the choice of which depends on the first value. For example, frequency is only an option when measuring AC signals. The third display at the bottom of the screen is for statistics and limits. We'll discuss both of these in more detail a bit later in this presentation. One second measurement option for voltage and current is showing values in dB or dBm. If dB is selected, the displayed values are relative to a user-defined voltage or current. For example, here the reference value is 4 volts and the measured value is 2 volts, so the difference is minus 6 dB. On the other hand, dBm measurements are always made relative to the reference value of 1 milliwatt. This is a common measure when working with RF signals. The dBm value is calculated based on a user-selected resistance. There are preset values for 50, 75, and 600 ohms, or any arbitrary value can be manually entered. The rate of the HMC's analog-to-digital converter is shown in the top left corner of the screen. There are three settings for ADC rate. Slow has a measurement rate of 5 measurements per second. Medium has a rate of 10 measurements per second, and fast produces 200 measurements in 1 second. The maximum measurement accuracy, or highest number of displayed digits, is obtained when using the slow ADC rate, and the fastest measurement update rate occurs when ADC rate is set to fast. Triggering defines how measurements are started and stopped, and the trigger types and parameters are configured using the trigger hard key. There are three trigger modes: manual, single, and auto. In manual mode, measurements are started and stopped by pressing the trigger hard key. In single mode, the user defines a count, which is the number of measurements to make, and an interval, which is how far apart these measurements are in time. Measurements begin once the trigger is enabled. The default mode is auto, in which measurements are made continuously. This mode does, however, allow a threshold to be defined, above or below which measurements will not be made. Statistics on the HMC 8012 are enabled and configured using the measure hard key, and when enabled, statistics are shown in the bottom portion of the multi-value display. The stats menu is used to both enable and disable statistics, as well as to set the measurement mode. This can be either infinite or for a user-defined number of measurements. Note that if a finite number of measurements is specified, statistics can be reset and restarted either manually using the reset key or automatically by enabling auto reset. Limits are used to check that the measured values fall within a given range and are configured by pressing the measure hard key and then selecting the soft menu item Limits. Here, limit checking is enabled or disabled, and the high and low limit values are defined. These values, in this case 5 volts and 4.5 volts, are then displayed beneath the main measurement value. Color is used to indicate the limit state. Green indicates that the measured value is within the limits, and red is used to show that the value is outside of the configured limits. In addition, an audible tone or beep can be configured to sound whenever a measurement value falls outside of the limit ranges. The HMC 8012 can store or log measurement data to either an external USB drive or to its internal storage. This is configured by pressing the measure hard key and then selecting Logging. The storage menu is where the logging location, file name, and format are specified, and the logging interval, or time between recorded values, is user-definable. There are three different logging modes. In unlimited mode, Logging will run either until the storage medium is full or until logging is manually turned off. Logging can also be configured to log only for a defined number of samples, or it could run for only a user-defined period of time, entered in units of seconds. Our final topic is remote control. The HMC8012 can be remotely controlled over LAN, USB, or an optional GPIB interface, all of which are located on the rear panel of the instrument. The easiest way to interface with the HMC is using the free HME Explorer software package, which provides a graphical user interface for common tasks such as taking screenshots, logging data to a file, and communicating with or controlling the instrument via an interactive Skippy terminal. Note that the HMC also supports remote control and automation using the standard Skippy-based methods. Please see the programming guide if you'd like more detailed information on using Skippy for programmatic control of the HMC8012. Let's end with a brief summary. The Rohde & Schwarz HMC8012 is a compact benchtop digital multimeter that supports a wide range of measurements. These include basic functions such as measurements of voltage, current, power, and resistance, but also measurements of quantities such as frequency, capacitance, temperature, etc. In addition, the HMC8012 supports advanced functions such as triggering, statistics, limit testing, and logging of measured values. The HMC has a high contrast display and can be configured and controlled through its front panel using a combination of both hard and soft keys. In addition, the HMC8012 can be remotely controlled or automated using either the free HM Explorer software utility or by using industry-standard Skippy commands. This concludes our presentation, Getting Started with the HMC8012 Digital Multimeter. If you'd like to learn more about multimeters, related measurements, or other basic instruments from Rohde & Schwarz, please see the links in the video description. Thanks for watching.